Good morning, good morning, good morning. Okay, we're going to try that again. Good morning, good morning, good morning. Oh, that's a little better, that's a little better. On behalf of the Master Class Committee, Richland County School District 1, our Superintendent Dr. Craig Witherspoon and Board of Commissioners, we'd like to welcome you to Lower Richland High School and to the 2024 Master Class. This is an excellent partnership that we have with the Auntie Karen Foundation that's been going on since, I think, 2013, and we look forward to many, many more years to bring wonderful artists to our buildings to share with our young people. And for those guests in the building, welcome to the greatest school district in the United States of America, Richland County School District 1. I have my sidekick here with me today, Ms. Hope Jeffcoat, who's representing the Auntie Karen Foundation, and she has a few things to say, and then we're going to get along with the show.
Good morning, everyone. Good morning, everyone. There we go. Again, my name is Hope Jeffcoat. I am the Master Class Coordinator. I'm sorry, let me let Mildred get it in. Go ahead, Mildred. Thank you. I am the Master Class Coordinator for the Auntie Karen Foundation. And you know, I was trying to think back there behind the stage. What did I do before I knew this existed? And I am so excited to be a part of this organization, the Auntie Karen Foundation. I've met some great people. The students, I mean, it's fun times, and I'm really excited about it. I hope that you guys sit back and enjoy the show with Mr. Donnie McClurkin. So before we go any further, we're going to call forth Ms. Masharia Adams from Watch Fox 57, our TV sponsor.
Good morning, everybody. I can't hear y'all. Thank you. My name is Masharia Adams. I'm a reporter here in Columbia at Watch Fox. I just come to bring greetings from our station. It's just so amazing to see so many talented young people in here. So let's give a round of applause for all the talented young people. The legendary Donnie McClurkin, he told us that it all started for him when he was just 9 years old. So I hope that encourages you all, that you all can chase your dreams and you can start now. So I hope that you enjoy your master class, and I hope that you take so much from this experience. Thank you.
We'd like to thank Watch Fox, and we'd like to thank all those persons who support the Auntie Karen Foundation and Richland School District 1. At this time, I have the great honor to introduce Ms. Karen Alexander Banks, who's the brainchild behind the Auntie Karen Foundation, and she has been working hard in the vineyard for years to bring arts to schools and kids, and we love this partnership we have with my good friend, Karen Alexander Banks.
Thank you, Karen. Hi, everybody. Thank you so much for coming. As I tell you every year, this is what God has purposed me to do. Literally 22 years ago, I stepped out on faith, and a part of that mission was to use the arts to empower, enlighten, and educate. And I don't do it by myself. There's an entire team that spends about 6 months planning this. And so if you are a part of the Auntie Karen Legends of Planning Committee, would you please stand and be recognized? Thank you. Trey Taylor has been a part of this vision since the beginning, and Trey, along with Hope Jeffcoat and Carrie Abel, are responsible for this day. A little bit about Auntie Karen. As I mentioned, our mission is to use the arts to empower, enlighten, and educate. And we've been doing that not only in South Carolina, but across the globe. And the Legends of Concert series is our way of paying tribute to those people who've made a significant difference in the world of the arts, especially music. And this year we're calling the concert a testament to our faith, because this is our 20th Legends of Concert. So I hope you get a chance to join us tomorrow night as we present Donnie McClurkin, Hezekiah Walker, and Marvin Sapp at the Koger Center. So once again, welcome and enjoy the show. And if you get a chance, if you look in the back of your program, some of you have this. And these are all the legends that we've brought in the past 22 years. Enjoy the show.
I see right now I'm going to have to fire my side dude. He left me already. And this is his district. But next we have on program, it's... Hey, Carrie.
Hey, Hope. Ladies and gentlemen, it is our distinct pleasure at this time to introduce the Lower Richland High School Visual and Performing Arts Department. They're going to do an excellent tribute to our guest, Mr. Donnie McClurkin. So at this time, I have the distinct pleasure of introducing the young people from Lower Richland High School Visual and Arts Performing Department.
is never enough. And what do you say when your friends turn away and you're all alone? No, no. Tell me, what do you give? We give it your all, and it seems like you can't make it through. Well, you just stand when there's nothing left to do. You just stand, watch the Lord see you through. Yes, after you've done all you can, you just stand. Tell me, how do you handle the guilt of your past? Tell me, how do you deal with the shame? And how can you smile while you're heart has been broken and filled with pain, filled with pain. Tell me, what do you give? We give it your all, yeah. And it seems like you can't make it through. Child, you just stand when there's nothing left to do. You just stand, watch the Lord see you through. Yes, after you've done all you can, you just stand. And be sure, be not entangled in that bondage again. You just stand. Tell me, what do you do when you've done all you can? Seems like you can't make it through. Child, you just stand. You just stand. Stand. You just stand. Through the storm. Stand through the rain. Through the hurt. Just stand through the pain. Don't you bow. And don't you be. Stand. Oh, 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 just stand.
In that for the Lower Richland Visual Performing Arts Department. Let's give them a standing ovation. Thank you, young ladies and young men. Thank you to the band director and the choir director and all those who participated. Let's give them another round of applause, please. It takes a lot to do that and come up on stage and perform, and they've been practicing, so we deserve to give them their glory while they are standing there, and we need to remember that. Next, we have Mr. Donnie McClurkin coming up, but we got to get the stage ready for him, so I'm filling in right now, and I might not be the best fill-in. One thing I will not do is not sing. There will be no singing from this voice today, ever. Now, if I had my saxophone, I could play, but I sure can't sing. So, ladies and gentlemen, my friend Hope Jeffcoat, who's my tag team partner, is going to do something now. You ready, Hope?
I am, Ms. McClurkin. I'm going to escort you to the stage. You guys, the choir sung most of his, we can walk, yes sir, most of his favorite songs, but I just want to add a few more in there. Stand is a great one, We Fall Down is a great one, but I'm always thinking about Make Me Careful, you know, and some of his other great songs, so we're going to let him come in his own way. Mr. Donnie McClurkin, you guys, give him a hand one more time. Thank you.
See, y'all black people's trying to make me cry. Tell me, what do? When you've done all you can, seems like it's never enough. Tell me, what do you say when friends turn away, you're all alone? Tell me, what do you give? Giving your all and it seems like you can't make it through. Well, you just stand when there's nothing left to do. You just stand, watch the Lord see you through. After you've done all you can, we fall down, but we get up. We fall down, but we get up. We fall down, but we get up. For a saint is just a sinner who fell down. To the students, I'm a little underdressed because I thought it was going to be a casual thing, and I came here looking like an old man with young clothes. But I've got my favorite hoodie on, and it just says, "Feel your feelings." And to every young person in this room, and some of you old guys too, it's good to be able to express who you are genuinely and not try to be anything else for anybody else. I don't hear anybody. Not trying to live up to other people's expectations, but the best that you can do and be. To be inspired by other people, but never, ever. You can be inspired by other people, but never, ever deny who you are. All right. Never. Look at your neighbor and say, "I am who I am." I'm talking to you little kids in the back, to you, y'all in the back over there, talking to y'all. Scream over there. Yep, I started it. So I don't know what I'm supposed to do. Auntie Karen, thank you so much for letting me come to your foundation. And this is the first masterclass I've ever done. Out of all that I've accomplished, I've never had the privilege of sitting before generations and talking about my craft and my gift. I've never had the opportunity to expound on what it is that God blessed me with. And I travel the world, but this is the first time I ever did this. So I want to thank you all. I want to thank you. Now, Madam Banks, I'm not quite sure of how this is supposed to go. Is this supposed to be question answer or just my story?
Right. We're going to let you share your story.
My story.
We're going to let you give some inspiration, and we will take some questions.
It was on November 9th, 1959, on a Monday evening at 7 p.m. at Lakeside Hospital in Copaig, New York. that a wonderful bundle of joy was delivered to Francis and Donald McClurkin. Amen. Yeah, and y'all can look at me, y'all know I'm old. I'm an old guy. I was born in 1959. I'm not talking to you people that were born before me. I was born in 1959, November the 9th. It's the same day Jesus was born. Jesus was born November the 9th, 2,000 years ago. If you can believe he was born on the 25th of December, I can believe he was born on November 9th. And we were born to a poor family, a very poor family, and an extremely poor family. And my mother and father, they believed in fighting, and they believed in having kids. So after every good fight, there was a child. There were 10 of us. 10 good fights, 10 good children. Yeah, and we were born 11 months apart, a year apart, and so everybody was just about the same age going down the ladder, and we would sleep sometimes 5 to a bed. I always had my sister's feet in my face. And we grew up thinking that everybody had the same environment we had. We grew up believing that everybody had rats and roaches. We believe everybody had something called government cheese. See, only the, now, young people, all the young people scream and make some noise, all the young people. Now, I did that because all you young people don't know anything about what I'm talking about. You have no clue what government cheese is. Only the old people know what that, all the old people scream in this place. See, these are government cheese eating people. That's when you were poor and you had to go down to the county or to the city and get supplemental food. We had food stamps, we had government cheese, we had peanut butter in a galvanized can that you, and Spam and powdered milk, yeah. Sardines and crackers. But that's how old people lived. That's how old people lived. I never thought that I would be doing this. I never thought that I would become a millionaire. I never believed or dreamed that my net worth would be over $5 million. I never thought anybody in my family could ever achieve that. And I surely never thought that it would happen through gospel music. But God works in mysterious ways, and he gives us gifts. That's why I pray to God that they never take the creative arts out of school, because there is so much invested in young people. How many young people sing, play an instrument, dance? If that's you, jump up and scream. I'll do that again. How many of you sing, dance, rap, produce, play an instrument, jump up and scream? That's the reason why they should never take the arts out of school. And I grew up and I learned how to play the piano because a man by the name of Andre Crouch prayed for me and laid his hands on me and said, God, give him what you gave to me. And that's how I got it. And then I started playing the piano and I never took any lessons. I just started hearing things. And then I started singing because my mother told me I couldn't sing. She was a wonderful woman. I came home from school, from church, and I had joined the choir. And the whole family, aunts, uncles, everybody was over. It was on Thanksgiving night, because we went to the church, they had an impromptu choir rehearsal on Thanksgiving night. And I went and I joined the choir. I came home, it's like, yeah, mommy, I just joined the choir. She said, oh, sweetheart, why did you do that? You can't sing. And sometimes even your parents don't know how gifted you are. Never let anybody extinguish your zeal. Never let anybody put your flame out. Because if I had listened to my mother when I was 14 years old, I would have never done any of this. But God, he has a special purpose for everybody. And you need to know that you are not just a blip on the screen. You're not just somebody here. I don't know who I am. Find out quick, because you're somebody special. Because I never thought that this would happen to me in a million years. I judged myself by my misfortunes. I judged myself. I was born with webbed hands and arthritis and with deformities. And I lived by that. I was believing that I could not accomplish things because of my webbed hands, my gnarled fingers, and my deformities. And it took real inspiration from God for me to be able to override those things. I was bullied through all of my life in school because of my deformities. Bullied from 4 years old kindergarten all the way to the 12th grade. Amen. Bullied, beat up, mocked, laughed. The only thing that got me through was a teacher by the name of Maxine Turner. She was our music teacher. And she would let me come down on lunchtime and sit in a piano lab and play and sing. And I would sit there at 16 years old and play, and she was a very, very robust woman, I'll say that. She was a very robust, very robust. Very, very robust woman. And she would sit while I played and she would get emotional. And she had a lyric soprano voice. And when she'd get really emotional, she'd do the... And she would leave the chorus room door open so that the teachers that were coming and the hall guards would come through. And before I knew it, I was sitting there with 30 or 40 people during the fifth period lunch period. And I would just sing and play. That's the only time I felt like I was somebody. Because first period, second period, third period, fourth period, sixth period, seventh period, I was nobody. I was nobody. I was the boy that was raped at 8 years old 3 times by an uncle. I was the boy that was molested at 14. I was the boy that was a throwaway that was never going to be anything because of my emotional and psychological dysfunction and breakage. Two words. But God. It's amazing how God, now I don't know what religions you all believe in, and I'm not here taking a survey. I'm talking about me. And I believe in God. Unashamedly, unapologetically, I believe in God. Now, if you don't believe in God, then just sit back and I'll tell you a tale of a faithful trip. I believe in God, and God had a purpose that went beyond the 3 rapes in one night, that went beyond the molestation of 14. It went beyond the deformation. It went beyond the bullying. That if I could just believe that there was something more for my life than that, one day that would pass by. And if I was strong enough, if I could just be strong enough, I would overcome what came to overcome me. And I got news for you. I made it. I made it. I had people tell me, nobody's gonna ever wanna hear your music. Nobody's gonna ever wanna hear your songs. Okay. And the first Grammy that I won, the first Grammy that I won, none of those people were there. In Los Angeles, nobody was there to hear my name called. And at the end, when I got my Grammy and I was going out, and I was going, they had a whole row of different television shows, the Jay Leno show, Dave Letterman, all these people, and everybody that won a Grammy, Taylor Swift won a Grammy, and everybody that won a Grammy was going down the interview row. And whenever I would come up, they would say, oh, your name, and my publicist would say, Donnie McClurkin, he just won for gospel. Oh, we don't do gospel. Everybody out of 5 different interviews. Oh, Donnie McClurkin, oh no, we don't do gospel. So I'm standing out there looking stupid and junk, wanting to cry, but I can't cry because I ain't no punk. And I'm standing there, and Beyonce came up and said, Pastor Donnie, I just won my first solo Grammy. I said, I just won mine too, and we're holding our Grammys up. And she said, oh, are you doing the interviews? I said, well, they said they don't do gospel. And the guy from Jay Leno ran over to Beyonce and said, Beyonce, can we do an interview? She said, no, I'm sorry, you don't do gospel. And she walked away.
Hey, so, Mr. McClurkin, at
are
this
time... Are you cutting me short and junk?
Trying to keep you on schedule.
I'm good. I'm loving this.
I know, but we got to take some questions from the audience, too. So we're going to give you 5 more minutes, then we'll start taking questions.
I thought this was a master class.
Yes, sir. I'm going to step back to the side.
No, go ahead, master.
No, I'm just trying to keep my job because I got to get the kids back to school at some time. So we do want the young people to give a chance to ask you some
yes.
questions. So we have some folks in the audience. We have a microphone. So if you have a question, you can come up here to Trey Taylor, and she will let you. Now, let's make sure we ask questions about his career.
You can ask any question you want. Come on.
Okay, here we go.
Come on. I ain't scared. I ain't scared.
Okay, my name is Layla Hopkins, and I'm from W.A. Perry Middle School.
Oh, come here, sweetie darling. Let me see your face. Come on, sweetie darling. Hi.
So my name is Layla Hopkins. I'm in 8th grade, and I go to W.A. Perry Middle School. And my question is, if you had a testimony, what would it be? If you had a testimony, what would it be to the youth?
If I had a testimony, what would it be to the youth? Oh, man, that I would tell you that if I use my testimony as an example, I would tell you, you can do and be anything that God called you to be without fail. I had to sing for Barack Obama's inauguration. And, well, both of them, I had to sing for both of them. And I went, and in 2016, when he was about to leave, and Donald Trump took over, and I'm gonna talk to her. And we had to do a concert at the Kennedy Center. And I and Mary and Shirley Caesar were the only gospel people on the whole program. When we finished, it was his last month. That was in October. He was going to leave in November. And I went and I talked to him, and he said, "You know, Reverend McClurkin, I never thought that I would ever do this." And he said, "And when I was a boy, I never thought that I would ever rise to this level." He said, "But my mother kept telling me, you could be the president if you wanted to be." And he believed her. And I tell you all the same thing. You can be whatever you want to be if you believe it and you work hard toward it. Youth is a playground for greatness. It is the growing field for greatness. And while you're young, achieve your dreams. Yes. Got it? Eighth grader.
Hi, Mr. McClurkin. My name's David Brown. And who inspired you to do your career?
Who inspired me to?
Your career.
Who inspired me? A guy named Andre Crouch, a guy named Edwin Hawkins, a guy named Walter Hawkins, a lady named Tremaine Hawkins, a guy named Marvin Winans, and a lady named Cece Winans, even though she's younger than me. And sings better than me and makes more money than me. Those are the ones that inspired me. And I took that inspiration, and that's how I won 3 Grammys and 2 BET Awards and 2 Soul Train Awards and 2 NAACP Awards and 13 Stella Awards and 3 Trumpet Awards. And that's how all this happened. Oh, yeah. We're gonna start. Okay. So, take note about who inspires you. Yeah. Take note about who inspires you and build on top of that. Yes. Got it? Now get on out of here.
So those who are in line now are the only questions we will do. We can't get any more after the ones who are in line now because of time constraints. So make sure you get your question in good. And if someone has already asked your question, give your time to someone else. Thank you.
Amen.
Hi, my name is Isaiah Goodwin. My question for you is, how does your industry shine through your performance?
I can't hear nothing.
How does your industry shine through your performance?
How does my, what?
Artistry.
Artistry.
How does my artistry shine through my performance? Well, simply, I write the song. Don't leave me, girl, don't leave me. I write the songs. I live the songs. The songs that I write and the songs that I sing have got to be a part of my heart. I very rarely sing anybody else's songs. I write the songs that I feel that I can experience and the like. So that's how my artistry impacts my life. Got it? Good.
Hello, Mr. McCarr, Mr. Donnie. I'm Kaden Goodwin, and my question is, how did you feel when you know that you was a gospel star?
How? Well, I'm still trying to figure that out. How did I feel knowing that I was a gospel star? Do you know what, what's your name?
Kaden.
Kaden? You know what, Kaden? Just about last month, I did something that I never do. I looked my name up on YouTube. And when I saw all of the different things that I didn't even know was recorded, and all the different people that I've sung with, and all the different milestones, Coretta Scott King, who was my great friend, Beyonce, the whole nine yards, Gladys Knight, who will be in town tomorrow, and she's 100,000 years old. And, you know, and when I saw, and it took me a couple of hours watching all the things that I did, I think that's when I really realized more than anything else how far I had come. And it made me feel good, real good. Thank you, son.
Hi, my name is Emerson Humphreys, and I want to know what you would say to the people who doubted you before you became what you are today.
Don't make Donnie come out. What would I say to those who doubted me? Nothing. Because the best sense of revenge is success. You don't have to say anything. So as you grow and become successful, never waste energy on people who did not believe in you. Never waste that time. Got it, beautiful? You got it? All right. Get out of here.
Hi, Mr. Donnie. My name is Alaysia West, and I would just want to ask you, what advice would you give to young singers like me?
What advice would I give to young singers like you? Everybody who's a great singer started out young. Everybody that's a great singer started out young. And you've got to believe that you've got something special. And singing is a craft. And you gotta always work at your craft. It doesn't just come through osmosis or just because. If you know you've got a gift, you've gotta work at it. And you gotta get examples of what you wanna sound like and what identifies with your voice and use that as a training. But never stop singing. Never stop singing. Got it?
Hello. My name is Lachey Wallace Hayes. I'm a school counselor at W.A. Perry. And today, this is just a divine moment, and I wanted to gift you a book that I wrote. This is my fifth published book called From Pieces to Perfect Peace, Overcoming Grief. My baby brother accidentally drowned Christmas 2021, and God and you have been really a big inspiration to me, so I wanted to just bless you with this book.
Thank you so much, baby. I appreciate it. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Olivia. The question I had to ask you was, what temptations did you have that almost stopped you from reaching your
I can't say because this is PG. This is G rated. I gotta keep it Disney.
She said, can you give her the PG version?
I can give you the Disney version. Yeah. No. What temptations? You know, growing up is full of it's full of stuff, and my temptations are a little too numerous to mention. But the thing that got me through it was, first of all, a mother who raised me well, a father who stayed on me like I was a project, and a family that kept me accountable. That's why to this day when I travel, I travel with my family. Because some of the temptations, most of the temptations, almost all of the temptations were averted because I had people that were close to me that were raised with me. So I was blessed to have the teachings of my mother and father and my sisters who didn't play games with nobody in gospel. You know, praise God. So those are the things that kept me from falling prey to all of the crazy things that happens out on the road. And that's the G version. Okay.
Yes. Hi, Mr. McClurkin. My name is Akira Whetstone from Creighton. I wanted to ask you, out of all the hardships that you went through throughout your career, which one really pushed you into pursuing your dream?
The thing that pushed me into pursuing my dreams was my hurt over people, like what my mother said. And I knew my mother loved me because she was my greatest cheerleader after I made it, praise God. But that hurt pushed me. That brokenness at 14 pushed me because she said I couldn't sing. And so I would play and I would sing, but I just was afraid to sing in front of people, but I would sing all the time. And not knowing that all the singing that I was doing was preparing me, and it pushed me into my purpose. Those are the things. Whenever anybody speaks against who you are, let that motivate you to become even greater than they thought. Got it?
Yes, sir.
Now get out of here.
Hi, Mr. McClurkin. My name is Ethan. But the question I have is, out of all your songs that you have sung, which one was your favorite?
I think a song called Speak to My Heart.
Can you sing it a little bit?
You devil. They told you to do that, didn't they? Yeah, a bunch of kids. Now, Ethan. On this song, when I recorded it, one of the background singers who flew in just to surprise me was a lady by the name of Whitney Houston. So when you listen to the recording and you hear, talk to me, talk to me, talk to me, talk to me, yeah, yeah, that's Whitney Houston. Okay. Just want to let you know. She's an old singer. She's an old singer from way back.
Thank you, Ethan.
She was like my sister, and I had to sing at her funeral. It goes, what? Wow. Wow. Speak to my heart, Holy Spirit. Give me the words that will bring new life. Words on the wings of fade away. Speak to my heart. Speak to my heart, Lord. Give me your holy word. If I can hear from you, then I know what to do. I won't go alone. Never go on my own. Just let your spirit guide. Let your word about speak to my heart, Lord. Give me a holy word. If I can hear from you, then I know what to do. I won't go alone. Never go on my own. Just let your spirit guide. And let your word abide. And that's all I'm going to do. If y'all come tomorrow, y'all can hear the song. All right,
thank you.
Ethan, I'm going to beat you up after this is over.
Hi, my name's Aubrey, and I was wondering, what was your favorite quote, and like, what does it mean to you now?
Say that again, sweetheart.
What's your favorite quote, and what does it mean to you now?
My favorite quote comes from Shakespeare. Comes from Macbeth. And it just simply says this. It says, neither a borrower nor lender be. For loan doth oft times lose both itself and friends, and borrowing dulleth the edge of husbandry. And this above all, to thine own self be true. And it must follow as night the day. Thou canst not then be false with any man. That's my favorite quote from William Shakespeare.
She asked, what does that quote mean to you?
Huh?
What does that quote mean to you?
What does it mean to me? It means don't borrow no money and don't lend nobody no money. Because if you lend somebody money, you're going to lose that money and their friendship. And if you borrow money, you're going to be lazy and not work. And to your own self, above everything else, be true to yourself. And if you're true to yourself, it will follow that you can never be false with anybody else. That's what that means. Bless you, baby.
Hello, my name is Payne McKeever from Dent Middle School, and I wanted to ask you personally, what is your greatest achievement of your career?
My greatest achievement is a boy by the name of Matthew. Is my son. My greatest achievement is my, is my 23-year-old son, who I love with all of my heart. My greatest achievement is my daughter, who I love, and her two children, who are my grand demon children. And I love them. They live in, my daughter and my two boys live in England, and so I'm Pop-Pop. And when they talk to me, they say, Pop-Pop, when are you coming to? And my thing is, shut up and sit down and eat your food. My family is my greatest achievement. And I'm a family guy. I love everything family. So I hope that answers your question. And I love your hair. Get out of here.
Hey, my name is Tatiana, and my question is, what is a difficult obstacle that you had to overcome in the music industry?
The difficult obstacle that I had to overcome in the music industry was the industry itself. The industry is something that you have to really be smart in, otherwise you will be caught in a web. The contracts that you sign, the people that work with you, the imbalance of equity, that comes along with it. And thank God, my dad used to say, God takes care of babies and fools, and I ain't no baby. And so God had to really help me through a lot of this, and I had a good lawyer, very good lawyer. And when the industry tried to, try to do the whammy jamma on me, I had a great lawyer, and I walked away with more than I thought that I ever would because of what they tried to do. So knowing the industry was key for me, and as I learned it as I went. Amen.
Hi, Mr. Donnie. My name is Madison Griffin Jones. I'm from Dent Middle School. I have two questions.
Yes,
one,
ma'am.
Which is your favorite artist that you've worked with so far?
My favorite artist that I've worked with so far is a lady by the name of Yolanda Adams. That's my favorite artist that I've worked with so far. We sang a song called The Prayer together. And she's like my sister. She should have married me when she had a chance, but that's another story altogether. But she's about my favorite artist, and CeCe Winans. Those are my favorite artists that I've worked with.
And can I take a picture with you?
You sure can. If you've got $200,000, you just come on. Come on, next question. Come on up. Come on. Next question.
My name is Justice from Columbia High, and I wanted to ask, if you could say anything to you as a child, what would it be?
You're trying to make me cry. Justin, I will scratch you. If I had to say something to the young Donnie, come on, stop this. Man, if I was to say anything to... I hope psychology is going to be your major. If I had to say something to the young Donnie, it would be, you made it. Don't worry about what happens in the interim. The last page of your book is, you made it. And it was all worth every pain. It was worth every struggle. The rape didn't stop you. The molestation didn't stop you. The bullying didn't stop you. Keep going, Donnie. you're going to make it. That's it.
Hi.
$200,000, kid. Okay.
Hi, my name is Tashiana Deschamps, and I wanted to know, other than Jesus from the Bible, what person has influenced your music the most?
Francis, Donald, my mom and dad, David, Pop Winans, Andre Crouch, Walter and Ed Hawkins. Those are about my greatest influences. And Barbara Streisand, don't forget her. Barbara Streisand. Those are my influences. From the Bible, you said? Other than Jesus from the Bible. Okay, Francis and Donald aren't in the Bible. Barbara Streisand should be, but that's another story. From the Bible, David. David, Moses, guy by the name of Noah. Those are cool guys. And of course, Jesus, don't forget him. Now get out of here. Yes.
My name is Mara. I go to Midlands Tech for audio engineering.
And yes, ma'am.
I want to know, what tips or guidance do you have for artists or just creative people in general who are around people who doubt them or just don't support their creative endeavors?
Understand that creatives are different people altogether. They're mystical. Creatives are mystical because you can create things out of the air. Dancers can feel something just by hearing a beat. You know, artists can see something other people don't see. Singers hear what other people don't hear. Musicians can pull sound out of the air and it goes through their mouth, through their feet, their hands. It's something totally inexplicable. You cannot explain it. And my thing is, stay around people of the same ilk. Stay away from people who put the light out. Stay away from people who don't understand, because they will try to bring you down to a level that you don't belong, simply because they can't ascertain to you where you are. Being different is not wrong. Being different is not wrong at all. Value and really appreciate your difference and never apologize for it, because you're a creative. Amen.
Donnie, we have one more question from this gentleman who is from South Carolina, and he was a Richland One. Oh, I'm sorry. Go ahead. Were you a Richland One student?
First of all, my name is J. Anthony Brown.
Hold on a second.
Oh, that is great.
Notice I'm in the middle?
Wow.
I'm in the middle. That's right. Because I'm taller and better looking than these guys.
Yes.
These guys, he's got a fake beard. This guy got a big forehead. I'm the cute guy in the middle. And if you tell them, they're going to beat me up. Here, Hope, take this for me. Yes, sir, I'm sorry.
How you doing, sir? My name is J. Anthony Brown. I'm from Columbia, South Carolina. I've spoke to you on the phone when I was on the Tom Joyner show several times.
Oh, Tom, yes, God. Yes, God.
Anyway, I have a question and then I have a suggestion. Listen. I'm a comedian, and people may not believe this, but I have a gospel song. I want to know, how can I get it to you? Don't laugh. Really, it's really you ain't even heard the song. Okay, and my other question.
I'll give you an email address.
You got it. Okay, and my other question is, do you think Kirk Franklin's clothes are too tight?
Good night. We make fun of Kirk. Now, Kirk is my best friend.
He's a good friend of mine, too. In fact, I call him God's littlest Christian.
He is my best friend in the whole gospel
music. He's such a nice guy. He really is.
We sit up for 5-6 hours talking.
You haven't answered the question.
And we have a running joke.
Yes.
The running joke, Israel Houghton, me, Marvin, Sapp, Yolanda, we say he buys his clothes at Baby Gap.
No.
He buys all his clothes at Baby Gap. His clothes are always two sizes too small. But, and he's so small you can pick him up and put him
and carry him around
in your pocket.
Not only does he buy them from Baby Gap, he has to have them altered when he gets them. Because they're too big.
You're trying to get me killed.
Nice meeting you, sir.
Brother, ladies and gentlemen, that is... Again.
God bless you.
God bless
heart,
you,
man.
Too.
Ladies and gentlemen, yeah. That is...
Oh, I was... Well, can I sing my song?
Wait a minute.
Sing your song.
Yeah. All right. Clap your hand. Clap your hand. I just got done talking to Jesus. Or you can call him anytime you want. I just got done. I'm talking to Jesus. Or you can call him anytime you want. Yeah. Or you can call him in the morning. Or you can call him in the afternoon. Or oh, anytime you call him, ain't never too late. Never too late. Ain't never. Don't steal my song.
No, it's safe. It's safe. Bless
and,
you, man.
And young people, just in case you don't know, Mr. J. Anthony Brown, who is used to be on the Tom Joyner Morning Show and is a national comedian, is a graduate of C.A. Johnson High School in Richland School District 1.
Yes, sir.
Okay, at this time, thank you for the wonderful questions and thank you for the answers, Mr. McClurkin. And you stay right there. We have a few presentations for you.
All right.
I would need Dr. Craig Witherspoon to come forward, Dr. Aaron Bishop. I need Ms. Latanya Williams, the principal of Lower Richland High School. Okay, I'm going to let Ms. Williams go first. Mr. McDuffie goes second, and then Dr. Witherspoon and Dr. Bishop will go last.
Okay. On behalf of Lower Richland High School, we would like to present you with this token of appreciation. So thank you for being here and being part of this program.
Thank you. Mm-hmm. Is there any money in this?
I don't think so. You're part, and this is part of it as well, our fine arts program. So
who did that?
Our art teacher.
This is what the...
So we are also presenting to you a portrait done by our art teacher here. His name is Mr. Joseph King. So this is being presented to him. Ain't it nice, y'all? Yes. This is really nice. I'm his booking agent if you need to get one done.
Oh, my God. You're his booking agent?
Yes, sir, I am.
Is there a check that goes with this?
So next, Mr. McClurkin, we have our superintendent, Dr. Craig Witherspoon, and our chairman of our board, Dr. Aaron Bishop.
To Mr. McClurkin, it has certainly been a privilege and pleasure to have you here, working with the Auntie Karen Foundation. And just a point of personal privilege, I consider your music to be my traveling music.
Amen.
You can be in the car, you can turn it up loud, you can get your testimony in, you can get that inspiration. And to the many generations that we have represented here, I was hearing some amens from young people and thank you, Jesus, from older folks. But your impact has certainly been great, not only in the gospel community, but certainly across music and faith. And your song, I know you hear this all the time, one of my personal testimonies in what we do in this district and in this community is Stand. Amen. Because those headwinds and shiny balls and all of those things will come. But that is truly a testament for the ages, testament across the country in terms of what's going on and how do we see our way through. And it's with faith, and you're putting that soundtrack to that testimony is just incredible. So thank you so very much for being here, sharing with our young folks. It is awesome. And this time I would like to turn it over to the chair of the Richland County Board of School Commissioners, Dr. Aaron Bishop, for a proclamation.
Amen. Thank you, sir. God is good. All the time. Amen. I think we got a church here.
Listen.
We are indeed thankful to you, Mr. McClurkin, for visiting Richland One. But what I do want to tell you, you will always have a home here in Richland One. Amen, somebody. And so as we are here, we thank you for the master class because certainly you are the master's piece.
Oh, thank you.
And as we are here today, we want to present this special proclamation on behalf of the Board of Commissioners, where I serve as chairman. Also, Angela Clyburn is our vice chairman, Robert Lomanack, secretary treasurer, Commissioner Jamie Devine, our parliamentarian, Commissioner Cheryl Harris, who serves this area with Lower Richland, Commissioner Tamika Myers as well as Commissioner Barbara Weston. And so as this day, we do honor you as an honorary member of Richland One because we're one team and team one. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
That's a good looking picture. I'm gonna go this way.
And we have one last gift, sir. One more. Okay.
They're taking another picture.
Yeah, that's why they won't make them. Yeah.
So we have one more gift. It's a small token of our appreciation from the Masterclass Committee. You see that nice banner?
It's a check?
No. I don't look good in orange, so I can't give you a check. So you see this nice banner here? We have a smaller banner just for you that looks just like that for you to take home and keep as a gift from Richland School District 1. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, before I let him go get some rest, before he takes off, because he has a concert tonight, we want to thank him, and I'm going to tell you why we're thanking him so much. Karen Alexander Banks has the vision. She brought him here. He came in last night. He is going straight to the airport from here because he has a concert tonight in Alabama. Then they will return in the morning to do the concert here tomorrow night. So that's why we were trying to keep the time schedule, because we cannot let him miss his concert tonight, because those folks are going to be waiting on him. But we want to give him a round of applause for all he has shared with us today. We have truly been blessed.